So, dear students, now we will discuss about a very important term in physics, that is unit. When we do some measurement of a physical quantity, we generally express it. Okay. So, to express any measurement of a physical quantity, we take the help of a term that is called actually unit. A very simple example is meter, kilogram, second. So these are the units of some fundamental physical quantities. So physical quantity means actually any measurable quantity. Any quantity that we can measure is called a physical quantity. For example, length, mass, time, these are the physical quantities. Actually, suppose someone is laughing very well. So, we cannot say that laugh is a physical quantity. No, we cannot measure it properly, though we may have some aesthetic value to that, but it is not a physical quantity. Now, it is very clear that when we do some sort of measurement, when we take the help of some instrument to measure something, so we say that quantity is physical quantity, and to express that measurement, we take the help of a unit. So that unit can be, means fundamental unit, or it can be a derived unit. Actually, that depends on what kind of physical quantity we are using. So, physical quantity we can divide into two parts. That is fundamental physical quantity. And derived physical quantity. Actually, at international level, so there are 7 fundamental physical quantities. So these 7 fundamental physical quantities are defined by international system. That is, there is an organized body, IUPAP. So they have developed these 7 fundamental physical quantities. These are also called base quantities, and it is believed that taking the help of these 7 fundamental physical quantities, we can express any other physical quantity by multiplying or dividing with the fundamental physical quantities. Now see, what are these fundamental physical quantities? One is length, other is mass, then third one is time. These 3 are very basic fundamental physical quantities. Then fourth one is temperature, fifth one is electric current, sixth one is amount of substance, seventh one is luminous intensity, amount of substance, and the seventh one is luminous intensity. Luminous intensity. You see, except these 7 fundamental physical quantities, 2 other physical quantities are also added. Means these are called supplementary fundamental physical quantities. Supplementary. So later on they are added. So supplementary fundamental physical quantity, FPQ. So these 2 are, one is angle, and the second one is solid angle. This, when we say angle, this means this is plane angle, and the other one is solid angle. Solid angle. So all together, if we say, then there will be 9 you can say fundamental physical quantities, 7 that are initially defined, and 2 later on added to that. So altogether 9 fundamental physical quantities. And to explain the laws of physics, the natural phenomena, there are a number of physical quantities. So except these 9, whatever other physical quantities there, that will be under this derived physical quantity. For example, force, velocity, acceleration, work, so many physical quantities are there which come under this derived physical quantity. Now see, in all these fundamental physical quantities, there is a unit associated with each one. When we do the measurement of these quantities, so some unit is there, and that is decided by the system international, means SI system, internationally accepted system. Okay, so that is followed in all countries of the world. So for length, so the unit is, this is actually physical quantity, and the unit is, I'm writing here, so the unit is actually meter. And for mass, the unit is kilogram. And for time, that is the unit is second, in short S or SEC, second. Okay, similarly for electric current, the unit is ampere. Electric current, the unit is ampere. And for temperature, the unit is Kelvin. Okay, so temperature, the unit is Kelvin, that is you can write K in short. And for electric current, the unit is ampere, that is A is written in short, capital A. And for amount of substance, the unit is written as mol in short, otherwise it is mole, mole. And the last one is luminous intensity. Luminous intensity is actually linked with radiation, black body radiation. So this is CD, candela, capital C, small d. So mostly we will be using these three, or in certain cases we will be using these five. These two will be very, means less used in our discussions, but these are all seven fundamental physical quantities. When we go for the supplementary fundamental physical quantity, that means for angle, we have the unit radian, RAD, and for solid angle, that is the unit is steradian, steradian, steradian. So this radian is RADIAN, radian. So these are the nine, you can say, fundamental physical quantities. No need to remember that how much length is 1 meter, though it is defined by SI system, how much mass is 1 kilogram, how much time is 1 second. All these things are defined by our international system of units, but no need to remember that definition. But just you go through that, there is a table in the book where it is clearly mentioned how much current is 1 ampere, how much amount of substance is 1 mole. Okay, and for this angle and solid angle, you see, angle is simply we write theta. This is ratio of two sides actually. So if these are the two sides, this is, let us say, theta, this is your L, arc, this is radius R. So this plane angle will be L by R. And when we go for the solid angle, suppose we have a three dimensional body like this, okay, and at a point, when we find out the angle made by this, so that is actually three dimensional angle, this angle. So this angle is your solid angle. This becomes equal to omega. This is generally written as omega. So that is some area by the square of the radius. This is actually radius and this is area. This is S. So this S by R square is called solid angle, which is generally expressed in the unit steradian, and plane angle is expressed in radian. Now let us discuss about some of the derived units, derived physical quantities. Their units are called derived units. For example, you see, if I write 1 newton, so newton is the unit of force. So we know that F equal to ma. Once you know the formula, you can very well express it. You see, 1 newton will be 1 kg into this 1 meter per second square. In short, newton can be written as kg meter per second square. So this is actually the derived unit, newton. Similarly, if you want to write the joule, so joule will be equal to, that is the unit of energy or work, that is force into some displacement. So that is means kg meter per second square into displacement means m. So this will be kg meter square second minus 2. This joule will be like this. So using this, actually, as I have told, by multiplication or by division of fundamental physical quantities, we get the derived physical quantities.
once we have the derived physical quantity, we can find out its unit by simply taking the help of the fundamental physical quantities. Similarly, so in your book there is a table, okay, where all the new physical quantities are given, their units are also mentioned. You have to learn them, otherwise you cannot go deep into physics, because when we will go to other chapters, this is actually the beginning chapter of physics, when we will go to the other chapters, we will be using these terms like force, momentum, work, energy, power, so pressure, so many physical quantities will come, so we will be using them. Now you see, in case of our derived unit, you see one is watt. So if you are told what is 1 watt, this is actually the unit of power. So 1 watt is actually power is given by the formula, power is work done per unit time. So this is W by T. So 1 watt will be equal to 1 joule by 1 second, you see. So it's very easy to define the derived units, derived physical quantities. If we know, just we have to express it. We know 1 joule is how much? 1 joule is, so 1 kg meter square second minus 2. So this will be 1 watt will be like this. So it will be 1 kg meter square second minus 3. So watt can be written as this, kg meter square second minus 3. Or we can also write that watt equal to joule second inverse. We can also write this. So once we know the derived physical quantity and its formula, we can definitely write the unit for this. So it will not be a problem for us once we have this. Now let us go for some of the measurements of length. You see, when we will measure length, okay, so basically there are the smaller units, there are also very large units of length. Smaller units include Fermi, Angstrom, okay, and micron. When I say one Fermi means 10 to the power minus 15 cm. Basically, in nuclear science, we will be taking the help of this. Okay, size of nucleus, etc. There we take the help of this Fermi. Or femtometer, this is also called one femtometer. It's a very small unit of length. One angstrom, when I say this, I mean 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So this Fermi is 10 to the power minus 10, minus 15 meter. This Fermi, minus 15 meter. This is called one femtometer. And micron is 10 to the power minus 6 meter. Okay, so minus 6 micron, which is also called micrometer. So this way the smaller units are defined. Similarly, there are also certain larger units of length. These larger units include, there are three terms basically. We should be very, very clear about these three terms. Larger units of length. The larger units include, one is astronomical unit, AU, that is called astronomical unit. This is actually average distance, between sun and earth. Okay, so this is actually astronomical unit, and its value is 1.496 into 10 to the power 11 meter. This is average distance between sun and earth, that is called astronomical unit. Okay, and similarly we can also find out this light year, another term, light year, ly, light year. So this is actually distance traveled by light, in vacuum, in 1 year. That means if light is allowed to travel for 1 year continuously in vacuum, the distance it will cover is called light year. You see, this is a very big unit of length. That big unit is actually 1 ly. Okay, 1 ly will be, you can calculate it very easily. In 1 second, light travels 3 × 10⁸ meters. So likewise, we have to convert one year into second. That means 1 year is 365, 1/4 day, and 1 day is 24 hours, and 1 hour is 3600 seconds. So light travels 3 × 10⁸ meter in 1 second, and 1 year is this much second. So total distance will be in meter, and if we calculate, this will be equal to 9.46 × 10⁰⁵ meter. You see, this is a very big unit, light year. Light year is actually the unit of length, though it looks to be the unit of this time, because year is there, but actually it is the unit of length. Similarly, there is another term which is called parsec. This is called parallactic second. Parallactic second, second, S-E-C-U-N-D. So this is also a bigger unit of length. Actually, when we say 1 parsec, this is defined like this. You see, when this angle becomes 1 second, and when this is 1 astronomical unit, this distance is called 1 parsec. You see, we all know in mathematics also that if this is theta, this is L, this is R, then theta will be equal to L by R, angle equal to arc by radius. You see, angle is also having a unit second. How? Now 1 degree equal to 60 minute, 1 minute equal to 60 second. So 1 degree will be equal to 3600 second. Now you imagine, 1 second is very small angle. Actually, just imagine a length, it's a very big length. 1 parsec is a very big length. Just imagine here, the angle will be only 1 second. In my diagram, it looks to be 30 degree, but actually it is 1 second. And this arc is 1 astronomical unit. Just from there, you go backward, so that these two will make an angle of 1 second here. So we have to travel huge distance. So that huge distance is 1 parsec. So very simple, means distance at which 1 astronomical unit arc makes a 1 arc second at a point. So that distance is 1 parsec. So you just refer to this diagram, everything is mentioned here. If this angle is 1 second, for this arc to be 1 astronomical unit, so this length, the radius, is your 1 parsec. So this 1 parsec is actually, if we calculate, it will be 3.1 × 10⁙ meter. You see, 1 parsec is equal to 3.1 × 10⁙ meter. This is a very big unit of length. So in this way, actually, we have calculated this astronomical unit, light year, parsec. You can also have relation among them. Okay, you can also have relation among smaller units like Fermi, micron, and angstrom. Okay, so in this discussion, actually, today we have discussed what is a unit, what are different fundamental units and derived units. You know, there are 9 fundamental physical quantities altogether, including your supplementary physical quantity. So except these 9, there are so many physical quantities which are called your derived physical quantities. Derived physical quantities will have units called derived units. So likewise, you can have the knowledge of this unit concept of this particular chapter. Thank you.